for the visitors. The Wildcats with Foster, Spratling, Williams, Owundu, and Gibson. By the way, Shane Southwell will play today. He's just not started. Now for the Sooners of Oklahoma, joining Woodard in that backcourt, Isaiah Cousins. Buddy Hield has really had a tremendous sophomore campaign. So too has Cameron Clark as a senior. And then there's Ryan Spangler, the kid from Gonzaga, who has just blown up this year in his sophomore campaign. Good for him to be back home. It's Kansas State in their road purple, and they have the ball first. Foster's got it on the wing, a three-pointer, and that rattles home. Boy, this kid can shoot. Marcus Foster.
Nice play off the flare screen for Foster. Always good to see one go in from beyond the arc to start the game if you're on the road.
Woodard is tripped up. That's a foul on Gibson, his first. And you look at Bruce Weber in his second year with Kansas State. And he'll have more wins in his first 2 years than anyone in K-State history. He has been terrific so far, of course, leading the Wildcats to a share of the Big 12 title a year ago. There goes Heald. Cousins for three to tie it up. Oh, that's an air ball. Wildcats, no secret, they've been bad on the road this year. Just 1-5, their only win at TCU. Last year, they were a good team on the road at 6-3. Bounce pass inside. Williams has it blocked. Lon Kruger, third year. Of course, a former Wildcat himself. He played and coached at Kansas State, but now in his third year with the Sooners, and looks like another NCAA bid for OU. Shot clock down to five. Spradling with Spangler coming all the way out to guard him.
Not the look you want at the end of the shot clock, Dave. You want to attack off the bounce, try to create something going to the rim in that situation.
Clark, no, off the heel. And one and done as Owundu grabs the rebound. It'll be interesting to watch Clark today. He was just 1 of 9 against the Wildcats in Manhattan, and there's a turnover by Owundu.
Cameron Clark, one of those players, Dave, that does better as a scorer when he sees some go in early. Really lets that dictate the rest of his game. He's got to learn to play through that, but it'd be big for the Sooners for him to knock one down early on.
Now, since that game against the Wildcats, Clark has sort of struggled, and we'll see if maybe today is the type of game that can get him out of that funk. Spangler, that won't go, but there's Heal.
Oklahoma able to get to the offensive glass because they spread the floor so well and create so many mismatches with their bigs' ability to step out and shoot the basketball.
Similar to Iowa State in the way they play, right?
Very similar. Fours and fives that can handle the basketball, make plays off the dribble, and shoot to 17 to 19 feet.
Tough to guard that. There's a Owundu. He loses the handle, and the shot clock is down to seven. And on the switch, Spradling goes right around Spangler and able to lay it off the glass.
The veteran move by the senior, the switch by Spangler. He took the big man on, attacked the basket at the end of the shot clock. Better execution than two trips before when he checked the three.
Woodard goes in now, heel, looked at a three, gave it up. Good patience by Woodard. Back out, Cousins just inside the three-point line. That's a two.
And that basket all because of Woodard's presence, patience, and poise. This young man's only a freshman, but he plays well beyond his years.
Williams, quick first step around Cousins and wraparound foul by Cousins.
Well, Cousins, a recipient on a nice drive by Woodard. Woodard plays so well and under control. He's able to get in the paint, break the defense down, not force it, found the open man on the perimeter.
Is he thinking pass first, do you think, when he's driving in like that?
I think the thing about him that makes him special for a freshman is he's thinking make the best play, whether that's a kick out or a finish on his own.
Heald for three. And that gives the Sooners their first lead of the game.
The number one thing you have to do against Oklahoma, Dave, get them stopped in transition and find number 24. Kansas State didn't do it, and it cost them.
Good dish inside, and then a good recovery defensively by Woodard to knock that pass out of bounds.
Well, it's hard to be a good transition defensive team when you turn the basketball over. Foster's on his heels backing up. You got to come up and match Heald as soon as he crosses half court. He's in range when he steps in the building.
How has Heald blown up so much here in his sophomore campaign? I mean, he's averaging almost 17 a game now.
I think, one, he can really shoot the basketball with range, but two, he's benefited from those skilled bigs we talked about and the spread floor. He's been a recipient of some open shots because of their ability to space people out.
He says it's just his time as Nino Williams slices in to tie the game at 7. Ooh, now that was some kind of a pick there.
Call that a pressure release.
Three-pointer good. Jordan Woodard. Foster. Did you see how many white shirts were around Foster? He still got it to the rim. Clark with the rebound. Now Heald again. Step back. Three-pointer, no. Spangler keeps it alive. Poked out of bounds. It'll go to Oklahoma when we return. So the Wildcats come over to their bench, and then there's Spangler and the Sooners, who lead by 3, and we're back after this from our friends at Phillips 66. Started off missing their first 3 shots. Since then, they're 4 of their last 5 and have a 3-point advantage. When they met back in Manhattan, it was Kansas State using their great defense, limiting Oklahoma to 33% from the field. And meanwhile, Marcus Foster was special with 18 points and 5 assists in the game. They really bottled up Cameron Clark in this game, but not Spangler. Spangler had a tremendous game with a career-high 21 points along with 14 rebounds. But at the end, it was Kansas State outscoring Oklahoma 16-4 in the final 5 minutes of the contest. Here, Oklahoma getting off to a good lead, 12-7 our score. Thomas is now checked in for K-State. So too is Johnson. Thomas looking inside. That ball was tipped. And then the official says, no, it wasn't. My bad.
Kansas State spent that entire possession just throwing the basketball around the perimeter. They've got to get it inside on a post touch or off some dribble penetration.
So that is now 3 turnovers already for the Wildcats, and the first 2 have led to 5 points for OU. Woodard, that dribbled off his ankle, and that'll be an over and back. The correct call.
It is the correct call. It's first touch, last touch. And Woodward was the last one to touch it. Even if it's knocked away by the defense and bounces off the offensive player, he's the last one to touch it and then the first one to touch it in the backcourt. It's over and back.
That's right. It is one of those quirky rules that probably should be changed. But it's a rule nonetheless in college basketball, not in the NBA. The defensive player knocks the ball away. Now, if it doesn't touch the offensive player and goes in the backcourt, that's not over and back. But since it touched him last, and it definitely touched him on the ankle, that is over and back. Owundu. Cameron Clark with another good rebound. Oh, what a pass in transition. Tremendous play by Heald.
Ryan Spangler runs rim to rim as well as anybody in college basketball. One of the things that makes Oklahoma so dangerous in transition is their ability for multiple guys to handle the basketball on the break.
Owundu tries a 3, and that stops a 7-2 run by the Sooners. A much-needed 3, and a rare 3, really, for Owundu, only the 6th one year.
He doesn't shoot a lot of them, but he's capable of making them. That was an important one right there. Get it back down to 2 possessions.
And now Booker from the wing. That won't go. Most of his shots are 3s. Look at Heald crash the glass. then Spangler was there along with Clark. They might have disrupted each other.
They fought each other for it.
You don't mind that as a coach, though, do you?
Absolutely not. That's exactly what you want to see. Guys going to the glass hard. You can live with it when it's an effort mistake.
Thomas has it poked away. Here comes Booker on the fly with Spradley. And that's a foul on Will Spradley. It'll be his first.
One of the challenges for Kansas State is that when Marcus Foster is not at the one, Javon Thomas takes over, just not quite as ready to run. The errant pass, good hustle by Spradley to get back and try to stop him. And Booker does a good job of attacking straight at the rim, and he's going to go to the foul line because of it.
Booker at 6'4", 200 pounds. I think he's a little more than 200 now. I think he's gained a little bit of weight since they first tipped the scales at the beginning of the year. Booker, a good-looking freshman from Augusta, Georgia. And wholesale changes now for K-State.
So a nice freshman class for Oklahoma. We have D.J. Bennett and Jordan Woodard, along with Booker, three freshmen that are going to be really good players in Big 12.
So Booker, who is a three-point specialist off the bench, he'll be replaced by Isaiah Cousins, who comes back in. And Buddy Hield will get a breather. Actually, Booker stays in and Hield goes out. So Buddy Hield gets his first break of the game.
Not a great offensive lineup in for Oklahoma right now. And only a minute to the media. Mark Kruger trying to buy a starter some time.
Southwell getting his first action in a few games. He missed the last two with a bone spur in his foot. Foster's three won't go. And there is D.J. Bennett, the junior college transfer out of Chicago by way of Indian Hills Junior College in Iowa. Hornbeek, who missed a few games with a broken foot. So both teams go into their bench heavily here. And Tyler Neal, who has really picked up the pace his senior campaign. Lawrence. And a whistle and a foul. And this one will be called on Booker. That's the first on Booker. Two team fouls on OU this half. And going to the line will be Amari Lawrence, a senior out of the Bronx. Lawrence, a 60% free throw shooter. Coach, one of the things that's just a head-scratcher with Kansas State is they were so good on the road last year, and it might be because they had more seniors and more experience and all that. But this year, to struggle the way they have away from home is just really a head-scratcher.
Well, a big part of it is that defensively they're giving up almost 12 more points a game on the road. And actually, Dave, that starts with struggling on the offensive end. We've seen a little bit of that already, leading to easy baskets for their opponent. When you struggle offensively, you're not going to be as good on the defensive end.
So we look at just field goal percentage, but a lot of it is points off turnovers, perhaps.
Well, there's no question. Giving up easy baskets, putbacks.
And there's Booker. A chance for another three. He's 0 for 2 from three-point range.
And if you're Kansas State, you got to find a way to get some easy ones yourself in transition on the offensive glass and out the foul line.
Southwell bounce pass to Gibson. Fight for the rebound, and boy, Bennett said this one's mine.
You've got to make layups when you're on the road too. Gibson with a little four-foot floater and missed it. Got to get those to go down.
Right now, with this lineup out there for the Sooners, they've kind of cooled off. Just two for their last eight. Hornbeek, kind of a one-man move. Bennett, though, able to tip it home.
Oklahoma puts so much pressure on your defense because of the ability to spread the floor and drive the basketball. They force a lot of rotations, and that leads to offensive rebounding opportunities.
Shot clock down to five. Good crossover by Thomas and a brilliant pass to Gibson.
Well, that's what Jabon Thomas does well. Create off the dribble and get in the paint. That time a little dish to Gibson.
I think Thomas, for him and for the Wildcats, Thomas's best days are ahead of him. When he gets a full year of practice and the offseason and everything else, he's just going to really settle in and be a good player for them.
And it's really ridiculous that he was not able to even practice while he was ineligible academically and first coming to Kansas State. He literally got thrown into the lineup in the middle of the season.
Southwell pulls up. Maybe a little bit of rust there. Here comes Booker in a two-on-one with Hornby and with Bennett. And that'll be a charge. So Thomas stood his ground, even though he had a guy 6'8", 210, bearing down on him. But Bennett, a guy that does a good job on the glass. And the Sooners keeping the Wildcats at arm's length. Teams have really cooled off of late. In fact, both are shooting under 40% for the game now. Oklahoma leading by five. You look at the standings in the Big 12, and Darren, this is really interesting as Kansas going for their 10th straight Big 12 title, which I just think is an amazing run when you look at the Big 12 conference or any power conference to have that kind of a dominance. But then there's Texas at 9-4. Of course, that's a big game tonight, Texas at Kansas. And a lot can be said there. And then Iowa State's playing TCU right now. These games all are so pivotal as we only have five games remaining in the Big 12.
And they're so important, too, because you feel like five are in for sure. They're battling for a 6th and 7th spot in the NCAA tournament. I think it should be a lot that the Big 12 gets 6 teams in, maybe even a 7th, depending on what Baylor and Oklahoma State can do.
They said to Baylor, they won on the road at West Virginia. Oklahoma State getting Marcus Smart back today. And they dominated against Texas Tech, and Smart was good. 16 points, 10 assists, 6 steals.
Pretty good when he wants to be, isn't he, Dave?
Yes, he is.
I think he wanted to let everybody know that he was back and his team is going to keep fighting and they want to be in the NCAA tournament.
Helped Oklahoma State stop a 7-game losing streak.
Well, Kansas State really struggling to finish at the basket right now. Give Oklahoma credit for that on defense, but also Kansas State is just, you got to make those shots on the road. You got to go strong and finish through the contact.
Well, that was a great move, too, by Spangler. He had Williams pinned, and then they just lobbed it into him.
And that's the difference on the other end. Ron Spangler on the nice roll off the ball screen straight to the basket with the left-hand finish. Did a good job of keeping his eyes focused on the rim and playing through the contact.
Spangler now giving Oklahoma their biggest lead of the game, and Spradling's coming back in for the Wildcats. Where Ryan Spangler was not recruited out of high school to come to Oklahoma. He had been a Sooner fan his entire life. Instead, had to go to Gonzaga, and then after a coaching change here, he decided to say, well, goodbye to Gonzaga. He wasn't sure he was coming back to Oklahoma. Wasn't even sure Oklahoma would be interested before they were. The day after he got his release from Gonzaga, Oklahoma picked up the phone and called him, and he said, yeah, he came in to visit 2 weeks later and committed right away.
And he's a difference maker because he produces every single night and gives you great production both defensively. You see the great help right there and on the glass on both ends.
How many times has the shot clock coach been under five when Kansas State has to throw one up? Tough shot there. Williams with the offensive rebound, then has it poked away. Sooners right now are just out-toughing the Wildcats, and that's not easy to do.
It's not, but they're doing a lot of switching, doing a good job of keeping the basketball in front, making it tough for Kansas State to get inside.
And when you get threes from Jordan Woodard, you can roll. That's what the Sooners are doing right now.
Just late on the rotation.
And Woodard now with a couple of threes in this game.
you know, as coaches, Dave, we always want to talk about you have to play through your bad offense. You have to defend no matter what's going on the offensive end. But that is so much easier said than done. And right now, Kansas State struggling offensively, and it's impacting the way they play on the defensive end. We talked about them not guarding as well on the road. It starts with them not being as good offensively on the road, and we're seeing that, especially in the last couple of possessions.
Well, that's for sure. The Wildcats have gone ice cold and are now just 33% from the field. Meanwhile, you look at Oklahoma. They have made more three-pointers in conference play than anybody else. And that's saying a lot because Iowa State lives and dies by the three.
It's an outstanding shooting team with multiple guys that get shots. And I love what Long Kruger just did, changing up the defensive look out of a timeout when he's got a little cushion.
Foster's two-pointer does not go. Clark with yet another rebound. Hasn't done much offensively yet, Clark, but he's doing a good job on the defensive glass.
You see Gibson matched up on Woodard. That's a result of Oklahoma offensively. Anybody being able to bring the ball up the floor. Kansas State never gets matched correctly. Leads to dribble penetration and a kick-out three.
Another one for Buddy Hield, and the lead expands to 14. Bradling just didn't quite have his feet set. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll belong to the Sooners when we come back. OU on a roll. And we're back after this from our friends at Phillips 66.
Dave Dare, look out.
Yeah, look out. TCU, they gave Kansas State a run for their money in a game you saw on Wednesday night in Manhattan. TCU just wonder if they have the horses to be able to finish here today, but that's a good lead for TCU in Fort Worth. With Darren Horn, I'm Dave Armstrong. Glad to have you courtside with us here in Norman, where the Wildcats have gone ice cold. They're just two for their last 12, and one of the reasons they're struggling, they just can't get anything going offensively in this game. Meanwhile, Oklahoma is on a roll.
Well, Kansas State struggling because they're not getting any easy baskets, Dave. 0 points off turnovers. Second chance points are on the break. Got to find a way to get some of those on the road.
Pull up two-pointer. That's two for Cousins. A 16-2 run now for the Sooners. They're blowing this one wide open.
I'd like to see Kansas State get a post touch for one of their big fellows, or maybe Nino Williams in the mid post to attack Cameron Clark. There you go.
There's a post touch and a good play inside to DJ Johnson.
Hesitation to get to the rim, but lost balance and the control of the ball a little bit at the end. Probably should have made the kick out on that play.
Interesting matchup with Clark now guarding Foster. Spin move, and that's a travel. Another turnover. That's seven for the Wildcats. We invite you to play basketball at Phillips 66, a chance to win prizes instantly and shoot for $66,000. Phillips 66, proud to be here. For Bruce Weber and these Wildcats, still trying to encourage them to at least cut into this lead before the half comes here in Norman. 5:47 remaining. I think he is starting to try to wonder what in the world's happened to us on the road this year, because it just doesn't make sense. Now, some of them, late collapse, you know, the one at Baylor where they lost in overtime and all that, but...
Well, the other problem is they're on the road in the Big 12 Conference,
yeah,
and they're
right.
Playing a lot of good teams like Oklahoma. Oklahoma's out knocking down some shots, getting it going early, and you fall behind in league play against a good team. That hole gets pretty tough to dig out of. They've got to find a way to chip away at this lead, mm-hmm. and get it down at least into the single digits before halftime rolls around.
The reason for the timeout is Spangler had lost his shoe at one end of the court, and they gave him time to go and retrieve it and put it back on again. Neal tries the three. Boy, the threes are raining for the Sooners.
Well, Neal actually came in from the paint to float to the perimeter on that one. His man was stuck in help on the drive. They were able to kick it out for three.
Foster driving in. Tough shot. Neal able to guide it to one of his teammates. Wow, what a wraparound move by Hornbeek for the two. And another timeout for K-State.
See the drive and the kick out. Neal came from inside, so his man sees the drive and steps up for help. And then how about this unselfish play by Buddy Hill? And the little finish by Hornbeek with the dipsy do. And the best part about that play, nobody more excited than the guy that made the pass, Buddy Hill.
Lon Kirk has got to be thrilled, Coach, because his team has scored 15 of those 33 points off turnovers.
Keep in mind, this is the Oklahoma team that's been off this week. Got to take a couple days break. Got to work on some finer points, fundamental. They come into this game fresh. Kansas State, meanwhile, has been grinding. They were at Baylor, home against TCU, and now on the road at Oklahoma. I think you can see the difference in those two teams because of that.
19-point Oklahoma lead. No one really saw this coming. Southwell for three. That one go. Oh boy, I thought it might bounce in and then poked out of bounds by Gibson. It'll belong to OU.
A tough shot by Southwell. He was actually backing up on that shot. You want to catch stepping in to the basketball.
Nothing going right now for the Wildcats. They've gone ice cold. Meanwhile, the Sooners are heating up. They're 5-10 from three-point range. Overall for the game, they're also 50%. Another three. And Booker, who had missed three in a row, hits one.
And Booker doesn't care how many he misses in a row, Dave. He is not shy to put the next one up. And you like that attitude in a shooter, a guy that's fearless. I call them gunslingers. You got to have a few.
Another turnover. Here comes Heald. Thomas fouled him before he got to the rim, but Heald will be going to the free throw line.
Buddy Hill really makes the game look easy. He's able to impact it in a lot of different areas because of his length and athleticism, his ability to shoot with range. I think this young man is developing into a nice NBA prospect with his size,
really,
athleticism, and ability to score.
So they're saying it's a non-shooting violation. Hornbeek drives in. With a floater that'll go. Everything's going right now for OU. Good step through, and he'll go to the line as he is fouled by DJ Bennett. But it's been all Oklahoma of late. High fives all around for the Sooners, who lead 38-14. Thanks a lot, Doug. Boy, Baylor, that, you're right, Doug. That was a big win for the Bears. They're fourth straight now, and they're working themselves back into the conversation in the NCAA.
Well, I said last week, if Baylor can find a way to get to 8 conference wins in the regular season, get a game in the tournament, it's going to be hard to keep them out of the NCAA because of their total body of work, as they like to say, Dave. Some quality non-conference wins, a lot of top 50 wins.
Thomas, for him, it's been an adventure at the free throw line, but that was a good one there. And Oklahoma's just jumped all over the Wildcats here today. Oklahoma playing against Kansas State like K-State did against Texas at home a couple of weeks ago.
Life on the road is difficult in the Big 12 Conference.
Yes, it is. Nice touch by Spangler showing his range.
He credits Steve Henson, one of the assistants here at Oklahoma, saying that he really helped with the shot. He said, coming out of Gonzaga, I really didn't shoot the ball well. One of the things he worked on last year when he had to sit out.
Well, the best player in the building today that has worn a Kansas State jersey, either now or in the past, may be Steve Henson, outstanding player when he was with the Wildcats.
Turnover for K-State. 9 turnovers. This is not a team that turns it over. And today's game is brought to you in part by the Puerto Rico Tourism Company. Live your own star vacation story. Puerto Rico, the all-star island. Visit seapuertorico.com. Spangler almost lost the handle, able to grab it. Three won't go, but there's Spangler to keep it alive. Fields' three won't go. Spangler almost kept that one alive. In fact, he forced the ball off the hands of Spradling, and it'll stay with OU.
Spangler gets so much done with just effort and energy. He never stops moving, playing hard, and competing. I tell you, they're into coaching college basketball. They wouldn't take that guy in a heartbeat.
I agree. I don't think we talk near enough about Ryan Spangler in our conference. Here comes Lawrence. Almost turned it over, but didn't. And that's the first 2 points off a turnover for the Wildcats today.
We're 18 minutes into the game, and it's the first easy basket that Kansas State has picked up.
Sort of foul. This one is called on DJ Johnson. No, excuse me, on Javon Thomas. They got Thomas instead. They were both there, but Thomas whistled for the foul.
Got him for the arm bar and redirecting a little bit on the ball screen. Javon Thomas, an outstanding athlete, going to really be a terrific defender as he continues to mature and gain understanding about things like that play right there, Dave. Mm-hmm. Don't put your forearm on a player 25 feet from the basket.
And now the whistles are starting to come. There's been kind of a whistle-free half. This one called on Spradling, who's picked up his second. And that's team foul number 6 on K-State. Fresh 35 on the shot clock. Sooners have got it again.
Well, you know you're playing well when you've got 40 points and your leading scorer has not given you much in the first half. This is a very balanced and dangerous Oklahoma team on the offensive end.
And finally, we got into the bonus situation, and Oklahoma will go to the line shooting a 1-1. This is Cousins.
You know, we talked about Kansas State's road woes, and statistically, one of the things that jumps out is they foul much more on the road than they have at home, which is normal because that happens to road teams, but it's leading to more free throws for the opponent, and that's been one of the things that's hurt them when they've been on the road.
One of the things you don't want to see happen if you're a team, whether you're at home or on the road, you don't want to see the other team get comfortable. And Oklahoma's been comfortable here today.
You know, they really have. They're getting out in transition and they're moving the basketball around just a little bit too easy. There's another nice bucket by Kansas State. Now they've got two easy ones. Southwell, not himself right now. They just, you know, he's been battling the injury, the bone spur, and did not play in the last two games. And they're going to need him at full strength down the stretch.
Cousins, three-pointer, no. Spradling's got the rebound. Under a minute to go, first half. Big Three-pointer by Spradley. Inching just a little bit closer. Still a huge uphill climb for Kansas State. And a timeout taken by Long Kruger. That's the one you use or lose. So he'll design a play. Can't really dribble out the rest of the clock. So while they talk things over on this possession, let's take a look at our bold predictions brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings.
I don't think there's any question that the Big 12 gets six teams in the NCAA tournament, and Iowa State will at least be on the second weekend, if not further, in the tournament. I just think they're a nightmare matchup if you're an opposing coach and you've only got a couple days to prepare for a team that posts its point guard and runs its five off players to shoot threes. You just don't see that very often. They're a difficult prep. They can score when it counts. You know, as of today, the Big 12 has six teams in. It could go to seven, depending on what happens with Oklahoma State and Baylor down the stretch.
When you look at some Big 12 bracketology, and you look at where all these teams rank and the RPI and the strength of schedule and all of that, and that's one of the reasons a lot of people are talking about Baylor, is that strength of schedule at number seven in the country, and the fact that their RPI rank is still so good. And a win on the road today at West Virginia doesn't hurt the Bears at all.
Well, that's going to help, and they've also got multiple top 50 wins and the opportunity to get a few more before the conference season is over.
Woodard being patient. Shot clock down to 10. Cousins step back move. That won't go. Spangler, though, kept it alive. Now Lawrence has got it. And that's a foul. No shot. Foul on Cousins. Kind of a heads-up play there by Cousins, because it's only the fourth team foul on OU this half. Two, though, on Cousins.
Good thinking in terms of he's in the moment in the play and understanding trying to make a smart play, but he just traded a one-foot floater over traffic from midcourt for the opportunity for Kansas State to run a half-court set. Well-intended, probably not the best decision.
Right now, there's 22 points, the fewest the Wildcats have scored in any half this year. Did not leave the hands of DJ Johnson in time. So as they go off into the locker room, Oklahoma, who led by 25, takes a 41-22 lead into that locker room at halftime as we get you to Doug Bell in the studio.
Make Oklahoma drivers and finishers and not let them shoot so many open threes.
You look at our stats from the first half, brought to you by Papa John's. And again, turnovers, the biggest story, really, as Oklahoma jumps out to a 41-22 lead.
Well, the reason that's a big story is because that made Oklahoma plus 15 in the points off turnovers category, and that's huge.
So here's Kansas State. Let's see if they can hang on to the ball here in the second half. They are not a team that typically turns it over very often. Three-pointer from the wing is short from Foster. And a fight for the rebound and a whistle and a foul. So the frustration really starting to mount for the Wildcats here today. That's the foul on Foster, and that'll be his first.
I like Kansas State coming right out and trying to get Foster going, but he shot a fade three to the corner. Rather see him get something going into the basket in a game when you're down 19.
Foster now one of six in this game. When you're down this big at the half, coach, do you really try to dissect the game and let's play 4 minutes at a time here as Clark gets two more and he's fouled by Johnson?
Well, you do. You try to make it even one possession at a time. You're not going to get it all back at once. Guys, let's make sure we get a good shot on the offensive end and get our defense set and locked down. Too much dribble penetration by Oklahoma leads to yet another basket around the rim.
So Cameron Clark goes inside. Clark now with 4 points to go along with five rebounds. Foster drives in. No. That's the first rebound of the game, believe it or not, for Spangler. Heeled back out, Woodard. That three wouldn't go. Here comes Spradling. Now Foster. And that's what you were saying. Don't settle for a three. Go right at the basket, and that's what Foster does.
That's two possessions in a row that Foster's done it. He missed the first one, got that one to go down. Let's see if it can get him going and create some offense for himself. He's the one guy Kansas State has that's capable of doing that off the bounce.
How on the flip side, we've talked about how does Kansas State come back. On the flip side, how does Oklahoma stay mentally in this game?
Well, Oklahoma cannot relax. They got to make sure they continue to get good ball movement, like the inside-out kick from Woodard to Cousins on that play, and defensively stay solid, keep defending without fouling, and Kansas State off the foul line.
So Oklahoma shooting better than 50% now from three-point range. Thomas has it stripped. Heald just picked his pocket. Heald slices his way in for two more.
Well, it's twice in this game that Thomas has driven into traffic with nowhere to go, lost the ball, and then not sprinted back on defense. You got to get back, young fella. Can't drive the ball in to help turn it over and not sprint back to help your teammates.
Thomas turns the corner. Pass inside. Save, but to the wrong guy. And then a reach-in foul on Williams. That's the second foul on Williams.
And the team's third. The Wildcats is Johnson, number 23, and Southwell, number 1.
If body language is any indication, Coach, right now the Sooners, they've got their chest sticking out, and the Wildcats, meanwhile, are just kind of moping around the court. They just know they're getting spanked here in Norman.
Oklahoma's got a little bounce in their step, frustration setting in for Kansas State.
Almost a turnover. Somehow, Booker able to keep it alive. Now, three-pointer off the heel, no good. And Johnson is playing. Southwell, two-pointer that won't go. And a rebound by Hornby. Generally speaking, it's been one and done for the Wildcats. Spradling easily picks off that pass. Only the fourth turnover, though, for OU, and Southwell turns it into points.
Good bounce pass by Johnson. Look at Southwell, the easy basket at the rim.
Sooners really lucky to get that play in. Cousins whips a pass. Booker for three. The Sooners have hit 8 threes in this game. They hit only 7. They went 7 of 23 in Manhattan.
That was outstanding spacing by Booker. He got down to the corner on that baseline drive. Baseline drive, baseline drift pass.
And then Gibson goes inside.
The challenge for Kansas State as they're starting to attack the basket. Get a few more easy ones at the rim, but they're not in a position where they can trade baskets.
Right.
They got to find a way to get some stops to go with them. They can't make a run unless they put both together.
Cousins, he had such a good move, he deked himself. Now Foster.
Cousins with the shake. As you said, he shook himself a little bit. Led to the easy one for Foster on the other end. Yeah. I think he got so excited when he saw Gibson matched up on him in the floor spread. He got a little ahead of himself.
He did.
It's like that big lineman that picks up the fumble and thinks he sees the end zone.
Well, Gibson comes over, hedges off the screen, but runs into Hornbeek for a foul. We're coming back after this from our friends at Phillips 66. Well, Oklahoma used a 19-2 run in the first half and have maintained a big lead over Kansas State. 51-30, our score with 15-19 remaining here in Norman. Well, you look at our Wendy's Wooden Watch and some of the guys from the Big 12 Conference that are still very much involved in the conversation, including Marcus Smart, Andrew Wiggins, DeAndre Kane, And there's still time for Edgem. We also know that Joel Embiid is now on this list as well.
Well, all five of those guys are having ending years, and the thing that's impressed me about so many of them is not just the numbers they're putting up, but the fact that they're doing it with good efficiency.
Mm-hmm. Woodard looking in the corner. That call was partially blocked. Good block by Lawrence. I guess the good news for K-State is Oklahoma has a type of offense where they're not going to just sit and hold the ball and shorten the game by doing that. They'll continue to shoot, and if they continue to hit, they're just going to keep pulling away. But if they don't, it would allow the Wildcats to maybe get back into this thing.
Well, for all our Big 12 football fans, they're not going to hand it off three plays and try to burn that clock. They're going to keep throwing the ball down the field. Oklahoma's not going to change their style of play just because they're up big. If they shoot quickly and Kansas State can get some stops, it'll create some possessions and opportunities for them to get back in it. But as we talked about earlier, Dave, they've got to string the scores
yes.
and the stops together to cut into the lead.
Mm-hmm. Gibson in that earlier meeting against the Sooners, 4.6 rebounds. It's been a double figures 14 times this year. And a really good junior season. And both free throws are good.
Been so impressed with Jordan Woodard this year and his ability to not get sped up, play with good pace and poise as a freshman point guard.
Well, good pass inside. From Spangler inside to Woodard.
Well, right on cue. How about the awareness to get the pump fake to avoid the block shot and draw the foul so he can go to the foul line? This is a veteran move from the freshman. Slips behind the defense underneath, but gives a little head fake because he's aware that defense is going to be dropping down inside to try to block it and gets himself to the line.
Well, he knows how to get to the line, too.
Well, he does a good job of using his body. Again, he plays much older than he is in terms of his pace and his awareness on the floor. And that shows up in his ability to get to the foul line.
Woodard today with 8 points, or 7 points, excuse me, and three assists in this contest. Now 8 points. Away by Booker. Spradling hangs on to it. Inside Gibson. But then Spangler was there. Well, he recovered quickly. And with the alternate possession arrow, it favors OU. The Sooners will get it back.
Good recovery by Spangler. He never stops coming to the play. He's able to get a hand on it and block that ball. And when talking to Lon Kruger at practice, said that, you know, we really spent the week just trying to get a little bit better defensively, a little bit more physical, a little bit better with our rotations, a little bit better fundamentally with our hands and our talk. And we're seeing that today.
Mm-hmm. Poked away. Booker heads up play to keep it alive. And then from the short corner, two more for Cameron Clark.
That's the danger when you play against Oklahoma. Good defensive possession by Kansas State. They force a deflection. Bounces around and gets thrown to a shooter in the corner, and he knocks it down.
It just makes it tough, Coach, for the Wildcats to forge any kind of a comeback. Johnson tries the three. That goes. Nigel Johnson only his 12th three-pointer of the year.
I think the key to that one was it went inside first, and Gibson was able to throw it out to Johnson, spotted up, stepping into it with rhythm and balance.
Another good look inside. Easy points for OU, and Cameron Clark having a much better game this time around than he did the first time in Manhattan.
If I'm Cameron Clark and Buddy Hill and some of those shooters on Oklahoma, I'm treating Jordan Woodard to dinner. That guy sure does make people's life easier by getting in the paint, creating easy opportunities for his teammates.
Good look inside, and there's Lawrence.
Southwell, an outstanding passer for K-State, actually leads them in assist.
I guess he's what you would describe, Coach, as a point forward.
Yeah, he really is. He's a big guy that can defend them on the interior. He can rebound, hold his own in the paint. But he's got the skills to be able to face the basket, make plays off the bounce, and he's an outstanding passer with good court vision.
The last foul on Nigel Johnson is first. 16 fouls on K-State this half, only one on OU.
Give Lon Kruger and his Oklahoma team credit. They came out of halftime of the game, and it was very easy to relax and get sloppy in, and they stayed just as sharp on the offensive end and just as aggressive defensively.
We'll be watching some of the Winter Olympics, Coach, and it's sort of like that skier that has a good first run, but you have to back it up with a good second one.
You got to keep bringing it, and I think that's been the difference for Oklahoma today. The games that they've struggled in, and they've lost some leads in conference games this year, have been when there's been a letdown on either end of the floor, and we have not seen that today. That's a credit to Oklahoma.
Little housekeeping before we get back into action. Johnson, another three. Wow, how about that? Hit 11 all year and now is 2 for 2 in this game. And both of them pretty much the identical spot. Whip pass inside, and it goes out of bounds. And Nigel Johnson trying to help K-State forge a comeback, but they have a huge hill to climb. Johnson with a couple of threes, but the Sooners still lead by 19. That's Oklahoma 59, Kansas State 40 with 11:36 remaining. We invite you to play basketball at Phillips 66. Chance to win prizes instantly and shoot for $66,000. Phillips 66, proud to be here. With Darren Horn, I'm Dave Armstrong. Glad to have you courtside with us. You look at the Sooners tournament resume, and they look like they are solidly in the field.
Well, they keep stacking up quality wins. Really no bad losses, which is important.
Clark has it poked away. It'll stay with OU. And it's really great when you have no bad losses. And look at the quality wins. Of course, a lot of that a byproduct of just playing in the number one RPI conference in the country.
Oh, no question. An opponent's strength of schedule is at 7. So all positives for Oklahoma.
And Buddy Hield with 3 more. Hield with 13 now in the game. Sooners, a team that score 83 points per game. So they're tough to stop. Spradling can't hit that three.
Well, that entire possession, Kansas State played from about 5 feet beyond the three-point line, even all the way to the flare screen for Spradling. They've been better offensively this half when they've gotten something attacking the basket or played inside out.
Mm-hmm. That's his favorite move, isn't it? That little step back jumper.
Well, he's really gotten good at it because of his ability to gather himself and be under control and not fade away when he shoots the shot. That's the mistake most players make on the step back. He's gotten himself on balance and created a nice move for himself.
Seventh rebound for Clark, and what an outlet pass to Cousins. And the Sooners have stretched their lead to 26, their biggest lead of the game. Thank you. Would have counted had it gone. The foul here is on DJ Bennett. Big 12 is looking to reach 100,000 Twitter followers and offering championship prizes to do it. To enter for a chance to win tickets to the Phillips 66 Big 12 men's or women's basketball championship, follow the Big 12 on Twitter and visit the official contest site on the Big 12 Facebook page for more information. Cats. So far, Coach Weber hasn't been able to find the right combination, and time running thin now, under 10 minutes to go in the contest. Remaining games for the Wildcats, they have another road game coming up at Texas Tech, then Iowa State at home, at Oklahoma State, and Baylor at home.
And one of the challenges if you're Kansas State, and obviously this lead is very large, Dave, but with their style of play, you know, they're not a team that plays extremely fast. They're not going to change defenses and try to create a bunch of turnovers that much. They're a very solid basketball team on both ends of the floor, but that can limit you when you're trying to make comebacks from double-digit leads.
A wraparound foul by Buddy Hield. That's the first foul on Hield. Only the third team foul on OU this half. The three, got it. Wundu with a foul down the sideline. Now we have a 1-1 opportunity for OU.
Cousins and Williams with a little spirited chatter.
Ron Kruger's just telling his team to calm down a little bit. Down the sideline.
Wandu sprinting to cut him off, and a little overreaction there by Cousins. Wasn't intentional.
Mm-mm. Cousins misses the front end of the 1-1.
Ball never lies, Dave.
And they called the lane violation too. Not that it mattered. K-State had it anyway. Losing his balance, somehow got it back. Wundu tries another three. That one's way too strong. Cousins doesn't settle for the three. Hornbeek will take one, though. And Thomas has the rebound.
Oklahoma as good as anybody in college basketball, David. Getting down to the corners in transition to flatten the defense out and spread the floor. Got a great open look. Because of that on the last possession, just didn't go down.
So that's four fouls now on DJ Bennett.
A little shake at the top for Thomas. A good job of attacking the rim. This young man can really get in the paint off the dribble. He's got to improve his understanding and his leadership at the point guard position and his ability to knock down the open shot. He can get in the paint at a high level.
Thomas gets the free throws.
Oh,
Neal tries a three. That won't go. And the rebound to Williams. And a three by Foster.
Kansas State shooting at a high clip from 3-point. Makes him 7 out of 13 on the day.
Mm-hmm. Whistle, this foul is on Javon Thomas. He doesn't believe the call. 7:42 remaining, and the Sooners leading by 19. By the Cyclones in that game, they trailed early against TCU. Thanks, Doug. And as you look at the Big 12 standings again, there's that logjam with Texas, Iowa State, Oklahoma, Kansas State, even West Virginia. Now you have to add to the mix Baylor. They're now at 6-8. So they're in the conversation as well as Texas Tech at 5-9, along with Oklahoma State. So, I mean, boy, it's really, really tight, 1-9.
Well, I think it's the deepest league in college basketball without question because of that. You look at Kansas State and what they have left at Texas Tech, Iowa State, at Oklahoma State, and Baylor. Their last two games of the year are against teams that are going to be playing for the NCAA Live, so it doesn't get any easier.
Well, it doesn't. You look at Kansas State as they look up at that scoreboard and see they're on the tail end of a 70-49 score. Tough to come back on a team that shoots 67% in the second half when you're trying to make that comeback. Thomas draws the contact. Good ball fake. Now today's game brought to you by Puerto Rico Tourism Company. Live your own star vacation story. Puerto Rico, the all-star island. See PuertoRico.com.
Thomas is at the line because Oklahoma did not play personnel defense. You want Thomas at this point to shoot jump shots. He stopped in the foul line area, gave a head fake. Woodard left his feet, and he's picked up the foul. Stay down. Let him shoot over top of you and force him to make it.
Rebound to Tyler Neal. When you look at the improvement of guys like Neal and Heald and Cameron Clark and then getting Spangler and then Woodard to run the show. This Sooner team, I think a lot of people have really expected a big drop-off with Pledger gone and Ahmad Mbai, who surprised them by going out early, and then Romero Osby leaving.
I think what nobody counted on is, one, how good that young man is right there, Jordan Woodard, and how improved all of those guys you just mentioned would be. And it's not just one or two guys. We've seen improvement across the board from the Sooners. Credit Lon Kruger and his staff for player development.
So that's a fourth foul here on Javon Thomas. Tyler Neal going to the line, a 71% free throw shooter. The thing, too, is Coach Kruger kind of changed their offense. I mean, they're scoring 13 points more per game this year than they did a year ago. Much more up-tempo team.
Well, this is a guy that's taken five different schools to the NCAA tournament. Only coach in NCAA history, and one of his great strengths is adjusting to his personnel. And he's got the personnel to be able to spread the floor and bigs that can play off the bounce and shoot perimeter shots. And because of that, his team has gotten very good offensively with their ability to shoot the ball and take advantage of their personnel.
Marcus Foster has really had a good second half. He is 4 of 5 in the second half for 9 points so far after going just 1 of 5 in the first half. Foster is one of those kids that a lot of people kind of backed away from because he gained some weight after his junior year, did not do well in AAU camps that summer. And a lot of teams started to back off. K-State never did. Bruce Weber always felt like, you know what, we can get him to lose a little bit of weight. And man, has he been special in this freshman season. In fact, you know, you can make a strong argument for Foster for freshman of the year in the Big 12.
You know, I think if you look at just the numbers and what a guy means to his team, there's no question you could argue Foster as freshman of the year. Obviously, Andrew Wiggins and Joel Embiid have been outstanding for Kansas. But some of that is because they get to play off of each other a little bit. Foster is the focal point for Kansas State's team offensively, and opposing defense is trying to stop him, and yet he's been outstanding game in and game out.
There's been so many good freshmen, though, this year, and sophomores. I mean, you look at how young this league is and how good it already is. And, you know, I wrote a blog a couple of weeks ago about everybody talks about the freshman class, but don't sleep on the sophomore class. And most of the guys are going to be back. I mean, there are maybe three or four out of the 20 we mentioned that are going to be gone after this year. But other than that, a lot of these kids are coming back to play again.
A lot of depth and talent in the Big 12 Conference from top to bottom. Kansas State's got three very good ones. Bruce Weber and his staff. Associate head coach Chris Lowry is an outstanding coach at Southern Illinois. He's done a fine job recruiting.
Knock it out of bounds. The Wildcats relying heavily on a freshman class that includes Foster and Owundu in their starting lineup. Nigel Johnson and Javon Thomas back up at point.
Anytime you're counting on that many young players, regardless of their ability level, says a lot about the future of your program.
And Kansas State as a team, as Gibson gets to, that had to work around the unexpected defection of Angel Rodriguez.
No question. That's one of the things that you can't control as a coach is the late defection in spring. Foster filled in just fine in that role.
Technical foul has been called.
Kansas State against
So Nino Williams and Jordan Woodard got tangled up, and as a result, a double technical has been called. And the foul itself is on Isaiah Cousins. It's good officiating, just making sure this game doesn't get chippy.
Oklahoma, a very hard team to press, Dave, because they have multiple ball handlers, and maybe more importantly, those multiple ball handlers are bigs that can catch and make a good decision to make the second quick pass, which is the key to beating full court pressure.
When you're beating full court pressure with bigs, it helps, doesn't it? Because they can see up over those double teams.
Well, they've got the size to see over top, and normally they're not the guy that gets rotated to, so they've got an open path, so to speak, to be able to see the floor.
Nino Williams with two more. Sooners now showing more patience on offense. With the clock under 5 minutes to go and a comfortable lead. Fouled by Foster. That's the second on Marcus Foster.
Frustration foul by Foster there. He did a good job of keeping Hield in front, forced him to adjust a shot. You see him work to keep position in front, force him to adjust a shot, but then hammers down trying to block it. Those are the situations that as these guys continue to mature, these Kansas State freshmen will play with a greater understanding that, hey, you know what, I don't have to try to block this one. I just got to get my hand up, try to make him finish a tough shot over top of me.
Hield at the line for the first time today. He missed that first one. Good day, though, for Buddy Hield with 15 points. One of three Sooners who are in double figures. By the way, all five of their starters average double figures. And Spangler averaging close to a double-double with 10.5 points per game and 9.9 rebounds. Foster, tough turnaround three. Wow, what a play.
Well, Marcus Foster is a special player because of his ability to shoot with range off the catch like we just saw and create his own off the bounce. And what I like most about him is he's physically mature for a freshman. He can take that thing to the rim, absorb some contact, and get some hand ones.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Kansas State. It'll be OU's ball when we come back. K-State cutting into the lead. It's down to 14. We're back after this from our friends at Phillips 66. Well, welcome back. to Norman, Oklahoma, where the Sooners are keeping the Wildcats at bay, but Kansas State has pulled back to within 14. Sooners, though, today, Coach, they have been really special from three-point range.
Well, they've gotten them in transition, off dribble penetration, and when you watch all of these shots, the challenge of Kansas State is that too many of them have been open. See a few late challenges. You see a lot of rhythm, step-in three-pointers. And if you give this Oklahoma team time to get ready and shoot, stepping in rhythm, they're going to knock them down at a high rate. 10 of 23 today.
So look at the balance scoring for the Sooners today. This ball goes all the way into the backcourt. And it was first touched in the front court and then goes to the backcourt. And so that is an over and back. Kansas State on a 15-5 run. It's not quite over yet if you're a Sooner fan or a K-State fan. I mean, you've got to look at this now. Kansas State has just somehow inched their way back into this contest. And a good move by Nigel Johnson. Don't look now, but it's a 12-point game.
State's been solid so far. No fouls this late in the shot clock. Force a tough shot.
Clark pulls up. Two-pointer goes. So Cameron Clark, he's in double figures. The fourth Sooner to go into double figures. A little more breathing room now, but here comes a three-pointer rattling home for Marcus Foster. The lead is down to 11, 2:46 remaining.
I like what Kansas State's doing offensively, just running a great score off some baseline staggers, letting them go to work.
Send Buddy Heel to the line.
Gibson was doing his best to stay in front, helping on the dribble handoff. He made the call on Foster. Couldn't see from that angle if he actually hit him or not.
Yeah, third foul on Foster. Now Heel at the line. Sooners. They do a good job at closing games out from the free throw line. One of the better free throw shooting teams in the country. 74% as a team.
That's such an advantage down the stretch when you're trying to hold on to leads as they are right now. Kansas State's got the opportunity to look for a slip with all the screening action for Foster.
Angel Johnson's three comes up a little short. Contact by a Wandu. That'll send Hornbeek to the line. Oklahoma, the double bonus. Hornbeek, a 75% free throw shooter. Double technical call, this one on Spangler and Gibson.
Look, Summers must have heard something very specific on that one. Pretty hard to tell from where we're sitting. We're pretty close, Dave.
Yeah.
Didn't look too serious.
Foster's three comes up short. Spangler with that rebound. And now with under two to go. A valiant effort by K-State. Looks like it's going to come up short.
You again, Kansas State has stayed solid for 20 seconds. You don't want to foul in that situation. Mm-hmm. If your choice is to foul, then do it right away so you can get the ball back with more time on the clock.
Kansas State fouls on Marcus Foster.
That's four on Foster now. Back to the drawing board, looks like, for Bruce Weber and the Wildcats. Hornbeek at the line. He's 3 for 3 now. Not a long time for Oklahoma to celebrate here. He's clapping right now as Oklahoma leads it 82-66. We'll come back to Norman in a moment. We look at Oklahoma with 82 points here today. Kansas State 66, only 131 remaining. Take a look at our sixth man of the game, brought to you by Motel 6 and Nigel Johnson. A good job off the bench with a couple of threes in this game.
Another one of those talented freshmen from Kansas State. Outstanding recruiting class. Bright future for the Wildcats.
A 1-2. No one came over to guard him, so why not?
The thing I like about all the Kansas State freshmen, Dave, is that they're the kind of kids that are going to continue to get better and better. They're going to mature physically. Their games are going to expand. Again, keep in mind, Javon Thomas literally got thrown into live action without any practice.
Now here's Cameron Clark. He's got to be glad to have this kind of game as opposed to what happened in Manhattan when he went just 1 of 9 against K-State. In this game, he's got 10 points with 8 rebounds. Second half for Marcus Foster. This game basically decided before the break, Coach. And the reason those 10 turnovers so costly to Kansas State in that first half, especially when Oklahoma was able to outscore them 17-2 in points off turnovers.
They had a lot of easy baskets early and especially got them going from beyond the arc. And when this Oklahoma team is out in transition, and shooting the ball well from three, they're really hard to beat, especially at home.
And a timeout taken by Coach Weber. Not a popular timeout, but a timeout nonetheless. And it gives the walk-ons from Oklahoma a chance to get into the action. And that's exactly what Coach Weber wanted to do, too. And another three-pointer, the third one of the game for Nigel Johnson. Frischilla has it poked away, but a whistle and a foul will send James Frischilla to the line. Both of his points this year have come from the free throw line. Now, James Frischilla is a trick shot artist. Let's see what he does at the free throw line.
If you have not seen it, you must go to YouTube and look up his trick shot video. It's amazing.
We're talking to him yesterday about maybe trying to make one from the rafters here at Lloyd Noble Center, and he said they won't let him up there.
Risk management, I think they call it.
Yeah.
Well, if you're Kansas State, Dave, you've got to regroup from this, get ready to go play a Texas Tech team that's played well and given people fits in Lubbock. And Oklahoma's got to find a way to build on this win.
So Oklahoma moves on with their 20th win of the year.